support Interobank and Gracia Espinosa. And welcome to this episode on the Red Couch Podcast, Christine Siroyd Vandelaar. It's correct?
Yeah, that's right.
She is the transition, orientation, and first year manager. And we are going to talk about the orientation day. So, Christine, first question. What students are going to do in the orientation day? And what is this event?
Yeah, well, that's a great question, Gracias. Thank you for having me on. I just bumped into mother and son in the hallway and had this conversation with them. They're like, what do we do for the first day? So I'm like, orientation day. Orientation day is on Tuesday, September 5th. That's the first day of the term for the fall term. So new students come on orientation day. Returning students start classes on Wednesday. Day on the 6th. So first day is for new students coming to Fanshawe. We have great events planned at the London campus, downtown campus, all of the regional campuses are doing some great things too. So
It's important to clarify this because it's not only in the London campus, it's in all the campuses of Fanshawe College, and it's not only one day, it's more than one day.
Yeah, there's things going on like throughout the week. So what's the main part, and I would encourage every new student to go to their academic program orientation. It's pretty much mandatory as your first step in getting your bases at Fanshawe. So what that is each of the program coordinators has put together all of the information that students need to know to start their program. You can go on to the website at fanshawec.ca/orientation and look up your program schedule. Like, do that. There'll be QR codes at all of the stations on campus where you can put it in, type in your program name or code, and it'll give you the location and the time when to go. Most sessions are, like at London campus anyway, 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 1 p.m., and then there's some at 3 p.m.
All the day. So if you
throughout
miss
the day.
An event in the morning, no worries because you have more later.
No. You have to go to yours. Like, it's your session. If you're in business, it's when, whatever that time
important.
Is.
And I would like to say to all the students, the new students, that it's important to participate and to assist because, for example, I think in the last episode, it was an introduction as a multimedia reporter. I think I didn't say that I studied at Fanshawe College, broadcast journalism and TV news. And for me, it was very important the first day because it's not only of an introduction to you, to the professors, it's the way that you are going to know what you are going to do and you are going to meet a lot of people. So it's good because it's not going to be so rude for you the first day in class. And
That's
I really
true.
Think it's important.
Yeah. That's a really important aspect is meeting the other people who are going to be in your class. You're going to be with these people a lot, and it's a good first step. You're all in the same situation and kind of support each other. And that's one of the, you know, great things that I've witnessed over the last couple of years is the support that students provide to each other. And, you know, learning about the supports that the college offers, too. So that's another big part about what's happening.
No worries. We lost a paper, but yep. I don't lose my question because yes. You talk about the QR codes.
Yes.
But for example, I didn't see that QR codes. So I don't know if it's something new for this new year or
yes.
What is the difference between the last orientation day and this one?
Well, there's different programs being offered this fall. Mm-hmm. We have different rooms reserved for different programs. So and the time. So it's a lot of work putting it together. So one thing I would encourage too is if you've looked up your program already, look it up again because sometimes they change. Like, could be up until the end of Friday that you maybe thought you were in D10006, but maybe it got changed to D10032.
Oh.
So double check your room, like before you, the time and the room before you come on Tuesday, just so you know where you need to be and don't miss it. Like, get to your session.
Of course.
Yeah.
So the students have to apply on the website or how they can do it or they are going to apply for this information sessions with the QR code. Explain me, because
right.
I think
you don't need to apply to go to your session. You're mm-hmm. expected to go to your session. They book the rooms based on the number of students who are in the program. So that's why sometimes if there's more students, they need a bigger room. That's why the room might mm-hmm. change. So the QR code is just like a quick and easy way to try and find where you need to be and when you need to be. So that is number one, is get to your program session.
And be sure yeah. that you are in the correct room, the correct yeah. time, because it could change. Normally, how long is each session, Christine?
Well, it depends on the program. I would say 1 to 2 hours probably is how long the session is, because they're from like 9, 11, 1, and 3. So depends on the program. Some could go a little bit longer than others. But I will say then, too, when students come onto campus on Tuesday, September 5th, and they come into the front doorways, like at the BT building or in E building at the Oasis, I don't know, there's another door somewhere too. I can't think of it right now. But there'll be people there. We have students. We have staff. Everyone's going to be in a nice red T-shirt saying, here for you, ask me a question. And you go and ask them a question, and they will help you find your session. If you don't know where the room is, they will walk you to your room. So there's a lot of people around to help make it easy.
A lot of volunteers. They are going to help if you are loose, because Fancy College is very big.
it's a big college. Yes.
When you are here and you can expect it's going to be a very big institution, but when you are here, it's like, oh my gosh,
yeah,
I'm lost. So
yeah,
you can
it's
find
surprising.
These volunteers, and they yep. are going to help you in anything that.
Yeah, everyone in the
need.
Red shirts. We're going to have maps at each of the sessions too, with a line from you're here going to. You know, you need to go here for some of the sessions. The rooms, not like it'll show where their rooms are. So just ask for help. We really are here for you. Yeah.
All the orientations, all the informational sessions are going to be in person, or there are some sessions online? Because the last year, I remember some of them were online.
Yes. So. Most are in person, but we have a lot of online programs. So the online program sessions will be offered online. Yeah, and that will mm-hmm. be on the schedule. Like when you go on to mm-hmm. fanshawc.ca/orientation and go to the schedule link, it'll tell you if it's in person or online.
If they want to come in person, for example, here, to come in person to the campus of London, they can take the bus, or I mean, because there are students around the college, but it's easy to come here. I mean, it's not going to be difficult.
It's easy to come here. So I'll do a little plug for the fan card office. I know a lot of information has gone up. People need to go to the fan card website and upload their photo. So hopefully most people have done that already. And you upload your photo, and then you can pick up your fan card. And I know I've seen a lot of new students on campus already getting their fan card, because it is used for many, many things around the campus. Number one, it's your ID. You can put money on it, like to pay for things around campus. You can use it to access your rooms if you have different labs and things like that. And it's your bus pass for in-person students at one of the London campuses. The regional campuses, they don't have buses in their town, so that's not included there, but it is arranged with the FSU that they have a bus pass, and then so that's how you should come to campus. I believe on orientation day, there is complimentary parking in one of the parking lots. I don't know if it's 5 or 6, but one of the parking lots on that day, you can come and park. But then after that, you mm-hmm. probably by bus is the best way.
Sounds good. The fan card is important for all the reasons that you say. But believe me, if you are in a broadcast journalism program or technology, you cannot enter in your class if you don't have your fan card. But for the first session, it's not mandatory. You don't have to pass the fan card, or it's mandatory for the first session to have your fan card to enter to the room.
No, we'll let you in. Yeah.
It's going to be, yeah, because yeah. I remember that in the first, in the information session, I didn't need the fan card, so it's good. But the following days, it's important that you get this phone card, because if not, you cannot enter in
class. That's right.
I have
That's
the experience.
Right.
after the informational sessions, there will be like events to meet people outside. I hope the weather
is going to be beautiful. It's going to be sunny and hot on Tuesday.
That's good. Yep. That's good. Yep. Because when it's, yep. I know the last year it was a barbecue, and I know this year we will have a carnival day, carnival after dark, karaoke. So yeah. Most of these events are outside. So I really appreciate that. In this year again, yeah.
Yes.
The weather is going to be is going to
we,
be good.
We will be blessed with good weather. There's a lot of fun activities planned, both social, and there's a lot of information sessions planned too to help students kind of get their bearings about services that are offered at college.
Mm-hmm. Because the services remind me, because I know the services will be included. The bus pass is one of the services, but I don't know if you can explain me more of these services, because you are the expert.
Yes, for sure. So there are a lot of things planned. So number one, I said go to your program session. Mm-hmm. And then number two, come down to the gyms, to gyms one and two. It's going to be set up. If people, you know, attended the open house session in March, it's going to be set up very similar to that, with all the student services set up around the gym. There's counseling and accessibility, sustainability, library learning commons, co-op, advising, and many, many, many more. And so don't be afraid to ask questions. Come and ask. If you need help with something, you know, you just ask. If someone doesn't have the answer, you know, that's okay, but we'll find somebody who does. And then so they'll come to the session, and the gyms are open from 10 o'clock to 3 o'clock. And then so you can pop in, you know, check that out, go outside to the carnival, have some fun, come back in. Like I said, it's supposed to be a hot day, so cool off. We have lots of drinks and everything in the gym, so they can come in and see that. We have some prizes to give away and some freebies, so come in and check that out.
The informational session, of course, all of them are free, but at the same time, all the events that I have mentioned, like carnival, mm-hmm. the karaoke, are free too, so you don't have to spend money to enjoy and to...
Right, that's right. So there's a barbecue on the Oasis patio, and I think that's from 11 till, I don't know, 1 or 2, I'm not sure.
Normally, last year it was until 1 p.m.
Oh, 1 p.m., okay.
1,
so,
2 p.m.
So there's barbecue there, free. Mm-hmm. And then there's lots of food, carnival type food. I think mm-hmm. there's like popcorn, residents having candy apples, and snow cones, and I don't know, just some cotton
all
candy type of stuff.
All the candy.
that people
like.
Yeah.
And in which part they can see all the events, are going to follow in these days, on the website or?
Yeah, so a lot of those things, if you go to the Fanshawe Student Union, fsu.ca website, and you go to events, all of that information is mm-hmm. there. It's a lot of fun things planned. So one of the other things I wanted to mention, Gracia, is in Gym 3, we are having information sessions, and I really encourage students to come to those. There is information. There's one on counseling and accessibility services.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. So, you know, it's they have a lot of great information, and it's just coping skills, like how to get help with technology, if you have accessibility, if you had an IEP like in high school, you have to come and let us know that, because it's a little bit different process here. Mm-hmm. And I'm not the expert in that. So if you come to the session and you do an early ID and let them know, then they'll get the services in place that you can use to be successful in your program. So that's one of the sessions. And then we also have student rights and responsibilities, and it's you know, it's about talking about academic integrity, student code of conduct, all the things that you need to know in order to be a good citizen at mm-hmm. the college, and everybody being able to work well together and have like a, just a good community. So that's a really important one to go to. And then at 3 o'clock, there's student services welcome. And that's where you get a nice little smattering, like all these different things that are going on, and get to meet some of the student services leaders from the college. And it's just a nice event just to kind of hear about what the library is doing, how they can help. And I'll tell you, I went last year, I was at the session, and it's eye-opening every time, just all the great things that are available on campus.
You mentioned a lot of services, but I have to say that, for example, it's so important you mention about the mental health, the yes. counselor, because the first days people are overwhelmed. Mm-hmm. So it's important. I remember that, for example, I had an anxiety attack, and I was super nervous, and one of the volunteers helped me that no worries if you don't find your, because for example, English is my second language, so for the international students, the first day is a shock. So it's important to know that there are people, not only volunteers, there are good doctors and people who can guide you in these difficult first days. And
yeah, that's
so
correct.
Important.
So that's why I like to go to that counseling and accessibility session. Mm-hmm. They'll tell you how to connect, you know, and it doesn't have to be like the biggest problems in the world. Mm-hmm. It's just like keeping everything together yeah. and
a
being
step
your
by
best
a step.
Self.
Yeah.
And yeah. Yeah, for sure. So, yeah, well.
And the library services, I know not a lot of people participate because they think they know, but seriously, it's so important for your projects, because they explain you how you can use the APA format here, very
yes.
important in all the projects that you are going to write. They are going to tell you how you are going to search on internet, research, important information that perhaps you think you know, but you don't know, seriously.
yeah, no, it's true. And at the Student Rights and Responsibilities, you know, academic integrity, there's a lot of talk lately about AI, you know, mm-hmm. like helping, you know, like with your essays or your mm-hmm. homework. And sometimes it's okay, sometimes it's not okay. So know it, because you don't want to be getting those mm-hmm. academic offenses at the end of the year. Like everybody, like just understand what... just what the expectations and what mm-hmm. the rules are on that. And then so that'll be explained too.
And I want to mention the sustainability organization, because mm-hmm. Fancy College is worried about the environment. So we know that not all the students recycle in their respective hometowns, in their countries. So mm-hmm. here you have to learn if you want to take care of the environment. And you are going to see not only how you can recycle, you are going to see a lot of different bins to protect the environment.
Yeah, that's true.
I think it's important to highlight the service too. So Christina, yeah. I don't know if you want to add something more.
Yeah, there's a couple other sessions I wouldn't mind mm-hmm. mentioning. So the military connected students, they're having a session, an online session. So, you know, we have a lot of students here who have served in the military, or their families have. So, you know, make a nice welcome environment and just provide the supports there. So there's a really good group of students there. FOL is having sessions, so Fanshawe Online, that is the student online learning platform. So sometimes, you know, new students, you're here, that's where all your coursework and information is, so it's a great idea to attend that. Mm-hmm. Or in the hallways, lots of times during startup, you'll see an FOL ambassador stop and talk, and like, just, you know, if that's one less thing that you have to worry about, is how to navigate, you know, this system.
I'm thinking the username and the password, because sometimes you register in the incorrect way, and after that,
yeah,
it's difficult later to download your the notes of your professor. So I encourage people to mm-hmm. to know how they can enter in their respective profile of FOL.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Right. At 4 o'clock, we're having a co-op and career services session. So if you're a student studying in a co-op program, I encourage you to attend this session, and you'll find out lots of information about how co-op works, what you need to do, meet your, probably like your co-op, mm-hmm. I'm not sure what they're called, the co-op coordinator, I guess,
coordinator.
Yeah, your coordinator. And yeah, so that's a really good session too. And then later in the evening for our online part-time students, we're having a virtual session. And just letting you know, like there are supports for online students too. I mean, you're still a Fanshawe student, just not here in person, but there's a lot of great ways that we can help, yeah.
Thank you so much, Christine, for this introduction to explain us the orientation day. I really appreciate all the explanation, not only about the informational sessions, about all the services that Fanshawe College provides. Thank you so
yes.
much,
oh,
Christine.
Thank you, Gracia.
Thank you for listening to another episode of the Red Couch Podcast. You can catch up with every episode on our website or wherever you get your podcast. You can do it on our website, on YouTube channel. And subscribe to our newsletter to keep up with Fanshawe for the Interbank. This is Gracia Espinosa.